We're now going to add ragdoll physics, which is quite easy in Unity, because all we got to do is right click and click on 3D object and click on ragdoll. The ragdoll wizard is going to come up, and all we got to do is drag in the parts. Hips is going to be pelvis. Left up leg is going to be left hips. And what's below that in the hierarchy is the knee. And the foot is going to be, I think this might be the right part. And then again, we do the same thing with the right leg. That's the knee. And then the foot. We now go into the left arm. The arm here. And then the elbow. Here, just call the forearm. And again, right arm, then the right forearm. We also put in the spine and the head. Make sure you've read the description and we click on create. If we look at the top of the hierarchy, we can see all the colliders now have been created. Except there's something wrong with the elbow here. If you're not happy with the colliders, you can always go back, click on Overize, and click on Revert All. But in this case, I think we just got to fine-tune the elbow. So I'm going to go into the left forearm. I think the axis is wrong, so we'll fix that. And we'll also make the position right. And the size. Okay. That looks about right. Let me take a look at it again. Looks good. I'm going to right click on the collider, copy component, and I'm going to go to the right arm, the right forearm, and I want to copy paste the values, paste component values. Except because it's on the other side, all we got to do is change this from negative to positive, and we have it on the same position. Now I'm going to go to the hand, and I want to create a sphere collider. These colliders are not only used in ragdoll physics, we're also going to use them in attack detection. So first we want to put them into the right position and size. Looks good. Then I'm going to go to the forearm. I'm going to copy the character joint and paste it as new. Except the connected body is now going to be the forearm, which is just above the hierarchy. And I think the left hand is done. And I'm going to copy the sphere collider and copy paste it into the right hand. Paste component as new. Except again, we're going to change negative to positive. And I'm going to copy the joint from the forearm, the right forearm. Paste it into the right hand. And drag the forearm into the connected body. I think it looks good. Except try to avoid the colliders touching each other. So I'm just going to increase the distance here. A little bit. I'll just make it 0.1. And same thing with the right hand position. Okay. And I'm mostly happy with the colliders, so I'm going to go ahead and click apply. The problem here is that all these colliders are going to interact with the box collider here, which should not happen, but let me click play just to show you what happens. So the character is just going to bounce off everywhere. We want to turn off the ragdoll physics if the character's not dead or anything. So I'm going to go into character control. And as soon as the game begins, before the physics starts kicking in, I want to turn it off. First, I want to move this code to another method. So I'm just going to create a method called set collider spheres. And I'm going to move these into the method. So now we just have one line here. And above that, I want to create another method, set ragdoll parts. First, I'm going to find all the colliders by using something called get components in children. That's going to give me all the colliders in the hierarchy. And for each of the colliders, I want to turn it into trigger. Trigger means the collider is not going to be a physical object anymore. It's going to go through every other physical object, except we'll be able to know exactly when other objects touch the collider. But we don't want to turn the box collider into a trigger because we want the character to interact with the physical environment. So if the collider that we found is not the same as what's in the character control, that's when we turn the collider into a trigger. And I want to go back up and create a list, a collider list called ragdoll parts. And just like the name, I want to put all the ragdoll parts into this list. So add them here and save. Let's make sure that we do this before the spheres here, because the spheres are colliders as well. We don't want to put them into the same list as the ragdolls. And let's go back and play. We can see all the ragdoll parts here, all in one list. And if we take a look at the hip, for example, it's definitely touching the box collider. But again, because it's a trigger, it's not going to interact with it like it's a physical object. I'm going to exit play mode. And at some point, I want to be able to turn on the ragdoll physics. So I'm going to create a method called turnOnRagdoll. And I'm going to do exactly the opposite. For each collider in the list, you want to turn that into a physical object now. And the box collider, get component box collider, we're going to turn this off. First, let me also turn off gravity from the rigid body. And if you want to remove all the velocity from the player, because it's a ragdoll, so I'm going to go to the attached body, and velocity is going to be 0. I think I should also turn the animator off, enable this false. Because we don't have any attack moves or any NPCs yet, I'm just going to create a temporary code. And I'm going to say, wait for 5 seconds when the game starts. And then I want to launch the player into the air just a little bit. Because I don't want the colliders to be touching the ground when I turn it on. I'm going to give it a few more seconds for it to get into the air. And then I'm going to say turn on ragdoll. This is only for testing. Later when we have attack systems, we're just going to use this line of code. When we turn on ragdoll, we also want to remove any velocity that is in the rigid body of the player. Go to Unity, click play and see what happens. So now we're going to wait a few seconds. I'm going to exit play mode, and I think the character is still affected by the animation. I'm going to go to Animator, and I also want to turn off the avatar. Save, and let's go back and play again. Okay, and for now I think the ragdoll physics is working fine. Let me exit play mode, and I'm going to get rid of this temporary code. We're not going to use this until we come up with some sort of an attacking system. Let me click play and check for bugs. So now the ragdoll is turned off. But looks like the raycast is still interacting with the colliders. I'm going to exit play mode and I'm going to go to move forward. I'm going to go down. And here, whenever the raycast hits an object, I want to be able to check if that object belongs to the player. So I'm going to look at the ragdoll parts. I'm going to look at the list. I'm going to look at the entire list and check that the game object is not the same. Or if it's the same game object as what the raycast is hitting, in that case, we just want to ignore it. I'm going to go back up and create a variable, a private variable called self. First, I want to begin with self is false. But if the raycast is hitting the player itself, then self is true. We break out of the loop and we say, only if self is false, then we return true for the raycast. That should ignore all the colliders in the ragdoll list. Okay, so walk is smooth again. In the next video, I think I'm going to use the colliders from the hand and use it to start punching. Okay, so thanks for watching. I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.